Hi, this is assistant Varun Krishna presenting on properties of f-divergence and information measures. This presentation is a review of the paper on divergences and information in statistics and information theory by Friedrich, Liese and Igor, Vajda. F-divergence is a function that measures difference between two probability distributions. They generalize many common divergences such as KL divergence, Herlinger divergence and total variation distance. It is defined as follows. Given two arbitrary distributions p and q over a space sigma for a class f of convex functions f defined over positive reals, Cesar defined f divergence as follows, where mu is a sigma finite measure which dominates p and q. So what is sigma finite measure and what do we mean by dominating a function? Let chi comma a be a measurable space. Now what is a measurable space? Let us suppose that set chi as a group of integers. Set A is a collection of subsets from chi such that chi is included in A. And for each subset, C in A, C component is also included in A. A map mu from A to positive reals is a measure if it's countably additive, meaning if it takes n disjoint subsets belonging to A, then measure of union of subsets is equals to sum of measures. The measure mu is sigma finite if there exist n sets belonging to A with measure of each set is finite and union of sets is equals to chi. Absolutely continuous. Let mu comma nu be measures on measurable space chi comma A. The measure mu is absolutely continuous with respect to mu. If mu of A equals 0 implies mu of A is also 0, which is also equivalent to saying V is dominated by mu or will represent with this. Let us look at some properties of f-divergence. Let P and Q be probability measures on non-trivial observation space. Non-trivial in the sense that A minus chi is not equal to phi. And P comma Q are dominated by sigma finite measure mu with genesis P equals to dP by dμ and Q equals to dQ by dμ. Then F divergence between P and Q is defined as this equation. And we divided the equation into three parts. With in the first part, both P and Q are positive. In the second part, P is 0. And in the third part, Q is 0. Adjoint function f star of t is defined as f star of t is equal to t times f of 1 by t, and f star of 0 is defined as limit t going to infinity f of t by t. Alternatively, f divergence can also be written as this equation considering only q. We take 0 times f of 0 equals to 0 and 0 times f star of 0 equals 0 even when f of 0 and f star of 0 are infinity. If Q dominates P, then F divergence between P and Q can return as this equation. As we can see that if Q dominates P, then this term goes to 0 and F divergence can return only this term. And if Q doesn't dominate P, F star of 0 blows to infinity and hence divergence between F and Q, P and Q also goes to infinity. Some more properties of F divergence that are worth mentioning. Let us define a class F1 subset class f with constant f of 1 equals 0 where f belongs to class f. Then f divergence between p and q is equal to 0 if and only if f belongs to class f1 and p equals to q. F star belongs to class f or f1 only if f does, and f star divergence between p and q is equal to f divergence between q and p, and hence divergence of f plus f star is symmetric in p comma q. If f belongs to class f1, then f divergence between p and q is greater than or equals to 0 and it's less than or equals to f of 0 plus f star of 0.
Now let's have a look at a few instances of f divergences. For the above classes of functions we considered, if f of t is equal to t ln t, we get the divergence between p and q as the k divergence plus a constant term. This converges to k divergence when q dominates p. Considering two other functions from the same class, we get the Hellinger divergence and the total variation distance, which are important measures in statistics and information theory. Divergences and Shannon information. Shannon introduced the information Ixy as the divergence between the joint distribution of random variables x and y and the product Px into Py of marginal distributions as the follows. Now, let's consider a theorem. For every channel with binary inputs, hypothesis and alternative, and with output conditional distributions P and Q over the measurable space chi, A, and input distribution with pi and 1 minus pi as probabilities, the Shannon information coincides with the f divergence of the output conditional distributions P, Q for f is equal to f pi, where f pi is given by the following equation. In other words, information between x and y is nothing but the f pi divergence between p and q. Now, from the definition of the f divergence, we have the following. When we have w is equal to pi p into 1 minus pi into q, we get f pi of p by q as this, which gives us the f pi divergence between p and q as the following. Now, according to Shannon's information definition, the mutual information is defined as follows. For w is equal to pi p plus 1 minus pi into q, we have the following. This term is written as following, where this term and this term are the indicator functions for hypothesis and alternate respectively. Integrating this, we get the mutual information as the following. After simplification, we see that the mutual information is nothing but the f pi divergence between p and q, which is what we stated earlier. Now, some final comments. KL divergence, Hellinger divergence and total variation distances are special cases of f divergence. Shannon information IXY is in a general output X of a channel with binary input Y is shown to be an F divergence on the conditional output distributions P and Q, which we just proved now. Due to the growing importance of divergences in information theory, statistics and probability theory, a possibility to simplify and extend the general theory of F divergences deserve attention. Thank you.